What's up, guys? So for today's video, I'm doing a how-to on how to count macros, how to find your macros, and how to just basically lose fat. We might also dive into how to gain weight and some things like that. However, we'll touch all that stuff here in a little bit. So to start, we need to go over some basic nutritional science for you guys to understand. Now in this section, I want to keep this very rudimentary. I do realize for some of you smarter guys watching out there that this is a little bit more complex than I'm going to make it sound. However, the goal for this video is to make a how-to that you guys can just take and go apply this to your life without being too confused. So I don't want to over-explain here, and I want to keep this simplistic for the viewers. So go ahead and tune in here. How to lose fat. That's usually the goal when someone starts a diet. Not always the case, sometimes they want to gain weight or put on muscle or whatever, but most of the time I think when people are Googling or searching how to count macros or how to diet, things like that, their goal is to lose fat. Now to do that, we need to just understand some basic nutritional scientific principles. Calories in versus calories out. Over here we have Henry. Henry's also over here, there's two pictures of Henry. Henry on this side of the calories inside is eating a slice of pizza. Over here on the calories outside, Henry is running and burning energy, or in this case, the energy is calories. Calories are what we gave the term for the energy our body uses. So calories in versus calories out, that is the key to fat loss. When we eat, say the slice of pizza that Henry has, there's a certain amount of calories in there that go into our body. And when we live or exercise or move or just breathe or the different things we do throughout the day, that requires energy, that requires calories for our body to burn, to keep us alive, to keep us moving, doing the activities that we're doing. Now, when we take in more calories than we burn, we gain weight. And when we take in less calories than we burn, we lose weight. That right there is essentially the goal to being able to manipulate your body weight or your body composition. Once you understand that, this stuff honestly becomes pretty simple. So, how do we take this and apply it to a diet? Well, there's one big thing that I'd like you guys to understand that I wish I knew a little bit earlier on. There is about 3,500 calories in a pound of fat. Now, this is kind of argued in the nutritional science world, but in my experience, this calculation comes out pretty accurate. Now you don't need to stress this number too much, but this is just going to give us a starting area to figure out how many calories we need to be expending per day to lose a good amount of fat. That's something that's tangible that keeps us motivated to keep going. Okay, now we're going to figure out how to calculate your calorie needs. Now you might be asking, why aren't we talking about macros? Well, in order to give you guys macronutrient targets to hit for the day, we first need to figure out what your maintenance calories are or what your caloric needs are on a daily basis. We'll get to the macros in a sec. Just have some patience and stick with me here. So we learned in the first section that if you expend more calories than you take in during the day, you will lose fat, and that there's 3,500 calories in a pound of fat. Don't forget those two facts. We'll get to that in a little bit. So here to figure out our maintenance calories, this is what's going to help get us to applying those macros to you, we need to take 14 to 16 calories per pound of your body weight, okay? Now, there's a lot more complicated equations out there you can use. I believe it's the Harris-Benedict equation to figure out your resting metabolic rate and blah, blah, blah. There's all these confusing things that I used to do myself. And to be honest, the more I do this, the more I realize simplicity is just better. It works out better in the long run. You're more than likely going to have to manipulate your macros and calories once you get going at some point anyway, so there's no point to being overly complicated about this. So what I do, and what Lyle McDonald, the guy who wrote the book Flexible Dieting, does to figure out maintenance calories, we just start simplistically by taking 14 to 16 calories per pound of body weight. If you're a little bit less active, and if you're a female, I would go on the lower end of that. If you're more active and you're a male, I would go on the higher end of that. As I said, in the future, it might change. So, over here is Henry. We have Henry again. I don't know why the hell I gave him a mullet, but Henry's got a weird mullet slash undercut thing going on. So anyway, Henry weighs 200 pounds. I don't know if you can see that written on his chest, but let's say he weighs 200 pounds. So all we're going to do is take 200 and multiply that by 15, because we just chose 15. It's perfectly in the middle of those two, and human beings like stuff to be exactly centered. So anyway, 200 times 15, that's going to equal 3,000 calories. So Henry's maintenance calories estimated are about 3,000. So all you have to do is do the same thing. Take your body weight, pick 14, 15, or 16, and multiply those two numbers together, and that will give you your maintenance calories. All right, now that you guys know how to figure out your caloric maintenance, we can take that info and apply what we call a caloric deficit, which is a fancy term meaning that you're eating less calories than you're burning during the day. We can apply caloric deficit to our caloric maintenance and figure out exactly how many calories you need to be eating a day in order to lose fat at a good rate. So we got sexy Henry with his sexy mullet over here again. 3,000 calories is his caloric maintenance. If we subtract 500 calories a day from that and make him eat only 2,500 calories, over 7 days, that'll equate to 3,500 calories. So we took 500 away from him daily over 7 days, that equals 3,500 calories. What was it that had 3,500 calories in it again? Pound of fat. Kudo points to you for remembering that. So we can equate about a pound of fat loss per week from just subtracting 500 calories from your maintenance. So you guys at home, whatever you figured out or used to determine your maintenance, just take away 500 from that number, and that is going to be your calorie needs for the day in order to lose about a pound of fat per week. Now I want to disclaim here saying because of water weight, hormonal issues, sodium and glycogen fluctuations, all sorts of things like that, you're not going to see a perfect 1 pound off of the scale every single week. You're not going to wake up, you know, 0.2 pounds lighter every day until it equates to exactly a pound of fat per week. It's unfortunately not going to work like that because of water weight and stuff. However, you can be pretty certain that if your caloric maintenance is somewhere around what you calculated it out to be, which it should be, when you take away 500 calories, you're losing about a pound of fat. We're going to talk a little bit more about that later and how to manipulate that if you're not losing at the rate you want to. But let's just stay on track here. In the next part, we're going to talk about how to calculate your macros, the good stuff. All right, guys, so we're finally getting on to how to calculate your macro targets for the day. Now that we know what your caloric deficit should be at in order to lose about a pound of fat per week, we can take that and this last bit of knowledge I'm going to drop on you guys in case you don't already know and figure out your macros. Calories per gram of macro. Basically, each gram of the macros, the fat, carbs, and protein, have a certain amount of calories per gram. So fat, as you can see I have written here, has 9 calories per gram. Carbs have 4 calories per gram, and protein has 4 calories per gram. So fat has 9, carbs and protein have 4. So now that we got this all squared away, where your caloric deficit should be at, and we know how many calories are in each gram, we can just take these calculations over here that I have written and figure out your macros. So the one thing you guys need to know is that fat and protein are essential macronutrients. You can't eliminate either of those completely without severely harming yourself or even causing yourself death. Carbohydrate you could have zero of for the rest of your life and actually live, but fat and protein are needed. So those are going to be the two we start with when we assign the macronutrients. So for fat, we're going to assign anywhere from 0.2 grams to 0.5 grams per pound of body weight. Which numbers you choose is totally up to you. You can choose 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, or 0.5. I don't care. Now you might be asking, where am I getting these numbers from? Where is this calculation coming from? This is just pulled from scientific literature to show what's optimal for body composition and health. If you want more specifics, ask in the comment section below and I'll happily link you guys to some studies. But for simplicity, just roll with this shit, man. So I took 0.3 grams of fat times his body weight per pound of body weight. So he is 200 pounds, don't forget that. And if you take 0.3 and times it by 200, you will get 60. So whatever your body weight is at home, if you weigh 150 pounds, just take 150, pick any of the numbers between there, and multiply them together, and that will give you the amount of fat you should be eating. For protein, it's very simple. Whatever your body weight is, just take that number and use that as protein. So for Henry, now that we have that solved and figured out his fat and protein, we can figure out his carbs. We take that protein, that 200 times 4, and we also take that fat, which has 9 calories per gram, and multiply that by 9. That will give you, if you do this at home, 1340 calories total. So that's 1340 calories. And that leaves us, if you subtract it from 2500, with 1160 calories left. Now, because we know there's 4 calories per gram of carb, all you have to do is take whatever that leftover number is, yours is going to be different, divide it by 4, and for Henry, that happens to be 290 grams of carbs there. So again, I just assigned 0.3 grams per pound of body weight towards his fat, 1 gram per pound of body weight towards his protein, calculated it out, and whatever was left over, 1160 calories, so what do I assign to his carbohydrate? So I just took this number, divided it by 4, and that gave me 290 grams of carbohydrate. So that's all you guys have to do to figure out your macros. I hope that made sense. In the next part, I'm going to go over what to do when you stall with your fat loss and what to do with cardio.